This video is brought to you by Storyblogs Video. People are saying that I'm starting to look like a mix of the Wolverine and Jim Carrey. I really like that. They're both my heroes. I'm not sure what you think what I'm starting to look like. Should I grow my hair, shave my beard? I don't know. Let me know in the comments below, guys. Anyways, it's been a little while since Taylor Swift came out with a new song, and she did, together with Brandon Urie from Panic at the Disco. They came out with the music video Me, and it looks awesome. It has tons of visual effects in there, and both of the artists have a great inspiration on me, so we just had to make a copycat video of them where we recreate an effect from their music video. However, the music video is packed with tons of 3D with high-end visual effects that is really hard to recreate. So we decided to pick an easy one out, and that is where Brendan kind of jumps off this balcony, grabs his umbrella, and then floating through the air. So for that, we have set up a huge green screen. Now, this is probably the biggest green screen that we've ever set up on the channel. And I hear you guys thinking, Jordy, I don't have such a studio. I don't have such a green screen. I can't recreate this effect. Well, no worries, because I want to focus this tutorial on something else, which is an incredible green screen trick that you can even apply on like a medium shot green screen or whatever. So without further ado, roll the intro. Hey folks, it is Jordy here for CineCam.net, and welcome to Copycat Friday. Now I want to start off with a big shout out to our sponsor, Storyblogs Video. Storyblogs is a huge library where we can find all sorts of video assets like After Effects templates, high-quality stock clips, transitions, video effects, and backgrounds. Now, what I love about the library is that there's only a single price per year, which allows you to download unlimited video assets without additional fees. Later in this tutorial, we're also going to see how easy it is to create your own fantasy backgrounds using two stock clips from Storyblogs. For more information about this incredible library, make sure to click the first link in the description below. Now for this setup, we are going to need a huge green screen. Janik, get! Our green screen seems to be a little bit transparent. You can see the background. You also run into this definitely if you're going to shoot outside. A simple fix for that is to work with a black cloth.
Get Jordan! Oh,
like this one right here. Behind me sits a green screen of 6 by 6 meters that we've attached to the ceiling of the studio, and that is needed because Lorenzo is gonna jump out of this elevator lift, then grab this umbrella in the air, and because he's making these big movements, we kinda need this big screen as well to make him fit completely within the green screen. If you're just gonna hang to just like fly through the air, then you can also work with a smaller, even a portable green screen, because you just only need to fit in yourself and that's like big movements and stuff. Now, lighting out a green screen is not always that easy because you want it to be lit evenly. A very simple trick for that is just to work with soft lighting. And because we have this huge fabric here, we actually opened up the dome in the studio because we are getting very nice soft lighting from the ceiling through there. Now, if you're gonna shoot outside, it's maybe best to wait for a cloudy day because the clouds are gonna function as a huge softbox for the sunlight, and thus you will have soft lighting over your green screen, and you will also not cast shadows as the subject on your green screen.
So for this effect, I need to be able to fly. So in order to do that, I attached climbing gear around my waist. But the problem with that was that the anchor point was right in front of me, and if I was attached to only that point, I would fall backwards. So the next solution was to turn the pants around. But then the problem was that I was constantly falling forward. So the next solution was to use these camera straps to attach around my shoulders so that the mounting point would be way higher right around my shoulders. And that made sure I was perfectly in balance.
Lorenzo is hanging from a sturdy cord because obviously we don't want him to fall. However, the umbrella is not as heavy as Lorenzo, so we can simply use some fishing wire. Just attach that to your umbrella, and this is not going to be visible on your camera, and even if it will, after we will pull the green key, this fishing wire will just be gone. And even if Lorenzo will pull too hard on the umbrella, the fishing wire will just snap like that, and we will still retain a natural motion. We have our shots, we can now bring them inside Adobe Premiere Pro. And since we've already done so many green keying tutorials on the channel, I'm gonna go quickly over it and give some more time to that nifty trick that I wanna show you by the end. Now, with your clip selected, start off by going to the effects controls and take the pen tool under the opacity to draw a rough mask around your subject and the clean part of the green screen. Then go into the effects library and pick the ultra key effect. With this, we can select the green and remove it. I'm gonna leave a link to an in-depth tutorial about green keying in the description below. Now we are left with a cable that is sticking out from Lorenzo's back. In Adobe After Effects, there's an effect called wire removal, but honestly, I'm not sure if it's gonna save you so much more time. So we are just gonna adjust our initial mask to also cover up the wire, then enable the animation for the mask path and adjust it over time. If you might have an idea to speed up this workflow of removing a wire in Premiere, then I would love to hear that. Just let me know in the comments. So once you're done, you can pick out your favorite background to place underneath the clip. I actually found a very nice sunset on Storyblocks together with an abstract visual. Now I blended the two together and used that as my background. Now, one of the issues that we are running into now is having a bright light source in the back, and we don't really see that come back on the subject. We've got a hard edge, and we actually want to have the light to roll over that edge. And to a basic extent, we can actually do that inside Premiere. To do so, I'm going to duplicate the green screen clip. Hold down Alt and drag it to the track above to do so. You can now disable the outputs of the other layers for a moment. On this duplication, I'm going to apply the paint bucket effect. Now start off by changing the fill to transparency, which means the entire keyed out subject. Next, it's gonna be important that you place your fill point on the empty space, or else it won't add the outline to your subject. Then change the stroke to actually being a stroke, and as you can see, this creates a perfect outline around your subject. However, we only need the outline, so from the blending mode, change it to fill only. And there we go! We have ourselves a perfect outline of Lorenzo. This already looks pretty cool as well. But for that highlight roll-off, we're gonna do a few more tweaks. The only thing left to do is change the color of the stroke to white or maybe a gently orange, depending on your background light. And finally, the stroke width, which we are going to set to around 5. And this is gonna be that edge light. Now it's currently pretty hard, so I'm also gonna add the Gaussian blur effect onto that layer as well and increase that a bit to feather the stroke. We can now enable the other layers back, and to make that stroke blend better, we are also going to change the blending mode of the opacity to linear dodge add or to screen if you think that is too hard. And there we go! We have the lights roll off from the background. Now, there's one last thing. Currently, that stroke also blends into the background, which shouldn't be. The stroke should only be on the subject. To do that, I'm going to apply a second ultra key effect underneath the original ultra key that was already on the clip. Now from these settings, we're going to use the choke to crop into the stroke, which will make the highlights roll off only on the subject. And that's it.
Lorenzo, what are you doing up there? Sit down, get back to work.
It's always the same here at Cinecom. I'm coming, Jordy. Woo! I'm coming, Jordy. It's gonna take a while though.
I hope you've learned something new today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks Video, for the support. And like always, stay creative.
This is the most difficult key I've ever done. It's 4:30 now, and I'm still keying. All because of Lorenzo's stupid curly hair. Damn you, Lorenzo, and your stupid curly hairs. Still not working, so I asked Jordy for some help. And now we're two guys keying and still not working.